The ayah does not apply, the ayat which you quoted, لا تتخذوا اليهود والنصارى أولياء, does not apply to inviting neighbors and colleagues, co-workers, citizens who are living with us in the same place, whether they are Jews or Christians or whatever, because we are commanded in the Quran to be kind to our neighbors, whether they're Muslims or non-Muslims. Surah An-Nisa, Allah the Almighty says, وَاعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا وَبِذِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْيَتَامَى وَالْمَسَاكِينِ وَالْجَارِ ذِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْجَارِ الْجُنُوبِ وَالصَّاحِبِ بِالْجَنْبِ. There are three types of neighbors that we must take care of and treat them kindly. Our neighbors could be neighbors and Muslims and relatives. That's one kind. Neighbors and Muslims, second kind. They have two rights. Or neighbors, but they're non-Muslims. They do still have rights upon us. Visit them whenever they're sick. Assist them if they are in need. Give them da'wah. And give condolence to their family members if they lose one of their family members. You know, these rights must be fulfilled. If you're talking about the ayat referring to al-wala wal-bara, who are Muslims, line up with their enemies against their fellow Muslims. And that is happening today. You know, Muslims seeking the help of non-Muslims to kill, suppress, and oppress Muslims by Muslims' money. Very common, very obvious, and that is seen. But that doesn't apply to inviting your non-Muslim neighbor or colleague so that you give him a chance to know about you and about your religion. Keep in mind that Qadianism, as I said, Qadianism is not one of the groups of Muslims or whatever. It's a deviant sect. They are absolutely non-Muslims. So when we deal with them, we do not deal with them because when they visit with us, they speak about Allah and Ar-Rasul and so on. Set this aside. If I invite them and my intention is to explain to them the truth, then this invitation, you'll be rewarded for it. You'll be rewarded for it because you're giving them a chance to know about the truth. Unfortunately, most people who are born and raised following a particular sect or a particular denomination, they were not exposed to the truth and they believe they're the only right people. Imagine when somebody is worshipping a snake or a cow or a rat, or somebody believes that he's a Muslim, but he or she believes that there was a prophet after Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they do have a different Quran, and some of the mandates of Islam have been waived. So they are in a state of ignorance. It is my duty to deliver the clear message to them. So obviously, via inviting them, I will get a chance to do so.